Hey guys, today I'm going to address the question, should you use an ND filter when you record video? And yeah guys, creating video becomes more and more popular with a lot of people, especially YouTube has gone through this rapid growth phase. And for all of you guys who are new creating video content, whether it's for YouTube or whether it's privately, you may have seen that some people create very, very nice images and results with their video content. And the question is, do you need an ND filter when you shoot video? And the short answer is
definitely yes. I would really recommend you get yourself an ND filter because it will enhance the image quality that you can produce significantly. And yes, of course, I'm using the Hoya Pro ND line. I have been using this for years now and I'm very happy with these filters. But of course, you don't have to pick the highest brand or the most expensive variable ND filter. In my case, I get very, very good results even with a fixed ND filter in a certain strength. And that's I also noticed, like, most people already struggle. At least the guys who are new is like, okay, now I know I need an ND filter. Which strength am I gonna use? Personally, I have the 3 light stops right here, but obviously that can be slightly different depending, like, for example, if you're in Florida where there's a lot of sunshine in bright conditions, you may want to have a little bit stronger of a filter going on as opposed when you're in Europe
like me, where the sun intensity might not be as strong and sometimes there are days that are overcast. Personally, I decided against the variable ND filter because they're simply more expensive and because I'm using my ND filter always in conjunction with a polarizing filter, so I have a certain variance where I can also change certain settings on my camera. But maybe, not maybe, you can clearly see in the navigation below, this is just the introductory part.
And in part 2, I'm just quickly gonna walk you through the settings that I usually pick on my Canon EOS when using the filter.
Because besides using the filter as a tool, it's also very important what kind of settings you pick on your camera to get the best possible results. So after I walk you to the settings in part 2, then next in part 3, I'm gonna do some test shots outside with this Hoya Pro ND filter, and then also some shots without so that you can see it clearly before and after and what kind of differences it makes in the video that actually comes out of your camera, which I know from experience is very, very, I would almost say it can make a somewhat dramatic difference if used correctly. And then in the last part, 4, I'm gonna give you a quick summary. So guys, why don't we just jump to part 2 and look at the ND filter and the camera settings. So let's jump to part 2.
So guys, and to explain to you the perfect camera settings and give you a general idea of why I love these ND filters so much, I just grabbed my iPhone and took a little bit picture behind my camera so that you can see what settings I'm usually running when shooting the product reviews. And because you cannot see that well here, I'm gonna do the following. I'm quickly gonna open the text editor and walk you to the settings. So maybe I can draw your attention to this top part here where it says FHD. Obviously that stands for full HD. And 25p is 25 frames per second. That's the resolution and frame rate that I'm usually shooting at. And in case you're familiar with videography, you may already notice that I set the shutter speed at 150. And why am I doing this? Why is the shutter speed twice the frame rate? Well, just in case you're new, there is something that's called the 180 degree shutter rule. And that's something I'd really recommend, if you never heard about that, look into. But suffice it to say that I tested it and it produces very nice results. So the bottom line is, while a photographer has no problem because he just shoots still image, he can change that. He's not bound to this fixed shutter speed. But obviously in videography, that's what we should use to get like this movie kind of feel. And that directly brings us to the third point, and that's the aperture. So as you have seen, frame rate and shutter speed are kind of fixed. We cannot change anything there because it's always going to be in that relationship. Obviously, you could choose 30 frames per second, but then again, your shutter speed should be 160. Now, if you're outside in an environment, maybe there's a lot of sunshine, there's a lot of light, even if you put the ISO pretty far down, I mean, I'm almost at the lowest ISO settings. I have 200, I'm shooting inside, it's overcast outside, and still I'm getting a lot of light into my camera. And in cases like that, if you don't use the ND filter, you would have to increase the aperture eventually. And the downside of that is, when increasing aperture, that may be a good way to show this. Obviously, this is a different kind of filter. I have a second video for polarization filters as well. But the point is, once you start reducing this aperture, you will lose this blurry background effect. Most people who shoot video, they want the blurry background effect. As you can see here, demonstrated in that shot that I did previously, the filter that I have here in the foreground is really nice and sharp, it's really crisp, and the background is really nice and blurry. The moment you are outside in an environment with a lot of light and you keep bumping up that aperture, you will lose all that nice blurry effect. So in essence, when you're shooting video, you're severely limited, because if you're in a high light environment, you can lower the ISO value only to 100. It's not gonna get any lower than that. And usually you want to shoot at an aperture. Personally, when I'm outside, I like to shoot at an aperture of 3.5. That's what my lens, the maximum that my lens can do is 3.5. And the ISO usually outside, I wouldn't like to have on auto. So, but the problem with that, with an auto ISO, is the auto function will regulate it down to 100, the lowest possible setting. And the video will be totally overexposed. There will be too much light. So the only way to do this is to use the ND filter so that you can maintain that nice blurry background effect. And obviously, if you don't care about blurry background, if you don't want to shoot video like that, maybe you can get away with just bumping up the aperture to a crazy high value of f/22. That also will constrict the amount of light that goes into your camera. But honestly, I don't think most people are gonna wanna work that way. So why aren't we? Let's just go outside and let's show you a few example shots of what happens when I change the shutter speed, what happens when I change the aperture, and then we're gonna do a test shot without the ND filter and one with the ND filter, then you exactly see what you mean. But basically, the thing that I want to point out, the ND filter is great to give you more flexibility if you're shooting in an environment where there is a little bit more light, and it removes that limitation of having to bump up the aperture. So without further ado, let's go outside and shoot the test footage. Those are the settings that I usually use when shooting inside my room, just in case. You see, it produces very nice results without the filter, but if it would be a day with that, where that would not be overcast with a lot of sunshine, I would even have challenges probably inside my room where I'm filming right now. So having a filter makes your life a lot easier. So let's shoot the test footage. Finally, let's go.
So guys, as you can see, we went outside and I just put up the camera to test the ND filter, and I can already demonstrate everything is overexposed. This is overexposed, this is overexposed, and the background is totally blown out simply because without the ND filter, there's coming way too much light into the camera. And just to recap the settings real quick, shutter speed is 150, twice the frame rate. The aperture is at 3.5 and the ISO is at its lowest setting, ISO 100. And maybe what I'm gonna do right now is I'm just gonna move this to the side, and you can see everything is really overexposed. There's just way too much light, and that really hampers the image quality tremendously. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just gonna take this filter out of the box and put it on the camera. And yeah guys, as you can see, the moment I put this in front of the camera, it really reduces the light. And here we have a boat coming by. Basically, the filter really improves it a lot. I'm just gonna screw this on real quick so that you get the complete picture. But yeah, I mean, that's what a filter does. It takes away the light and gives you the proper exposure for the video. I mean, you see the background now looks properly exposed. And maybe what I'm gonna do, put the ISO on auto. Now I put the ISO on auto, and I can just zoom in for you a little bit, guys. And you can see the stuff in the background is probably properly exposed, and I can also manually adjust it. Maybe let's zoom out a tiny little bit. Now we have the shutter speed at 150, the aperture at 4, and the ISO at 100. And if I want it to be a slightly bit higher exposed, I could always go ahead and dial in the ISO manually. I mean, right now I'm getting pretty good results. It's not overexposed. You see the sunshine is at the tree line back there. And if I go ahead and take the filter off again, you will see it's overexposed again. So the filter does the trick. And obviously, if you want to take it one step further, you use a combination of an ND filter to get the right exposure. And then you combine the ND filter with the polarizing filter and you get the maximum image performance. So make sure to check out the video for the polarizing filter as well. And yeah, guys, this is a second test for their ND filter. And as you can see, everything should be sharp. I mean, the sunlight hits me into the eyes, but still my face should be sharp and the background should be sharp. And if we want to have this nice blurry effect in the background, we need, under such conditions, definitely the ND filter. And that's why I'm gonna put on the ND filter right now. We're gonna check back whether we can get a blurry background with that. So guys, right now I put on the ND filter and changed the aperture settings on the camera and back down to 3.5. So, and the ISO I put on auto. And as you can see, my face should be sharp and maybe I can do a little bit of a turn here. And in the background, you should see everything is nice and blurry. The colors should look nice. And that's kind of basically the reason why when filming video, using ND filters or variable filters can really help you to produce really nice footage, not only when doing landscape video shots, but also when doing product reviews or even when vlogging. So if you see that really nice footage that some vloggers have, maybe think again, maybe it's just a filter. So that's why you should use filters when shooting video for YouTube. So guys, now we jump to part 4, the conclusion part. And what can I say so far? I'm really, really happy, and I can only encourage you to also try to test to work with ND filters if you haven't already done so, because as I have shown you at the waterfront, if you are working on your DSLR or mirrorless camera and you want to work with a low aperture value on your settings so that you get the blurry background effect, then really an ND filter is a must. If you don't have an ND filter such as this, yeah, obviously you could work around it by dialing up your aperture ratio value, but obviously I really like these filters. They come in different intensities and sizes, and you can perfectly use them to just get more out of your camera, because shooting photos and shooting video is like a little bit two different pairs of shoes. And lastly, the second thing I want to remind you of, I also have a video on my channel for using polarizing filters, because from my experience, using both polarizing filter and ND filter in combination really gives me personally the best results. And while you can work around the ND filter by just bumping up the aperture to have like these really nice crisp colors and eliminate certain types of reflections on surfaces like water, cars, and the like, I think the polarizing filter really is almost like a must-have that I don't want to miss anymore. And yes, guys, if you're asking, there are also videos for the Canon EOS M on my channel. Or maybe you want to see video camera reviews for the Nikon or the Sony 4K camera. I also have lots of other video and audio equipment videos and tutorials on my channel. So you are welcome to check those out as well. I see you as a subscriber and in my next video. All the best to you. Take care.
And guys, to learn more about audio and video equipment, you can now head over to my channel page and watch videos such as this about, for example, the Canon EOS M3 that I just used to shoot this review. And honestly, I'm amazed about the quick subscriber growth that I have achieved on my channel because of these useful product reviews and tutorials that I have here. And I see you in the next video and maybe even in one of my awesome online courses. All the best to you guys. Take care.